A sixth-generation fighter is a conceptualized class of jet fighter aircraft designed more advanced than the fifth-generation jet fighters that are currently in service and development. Several countries have announced the development of a sixth-generation aircraft program, including the United States, Japan, Russia, the United Kingdom, Sweden, Italy, France, Germany, Spain, China, and India. The first sixth-generation fighters are expected to enter service in the 2030s. So, what do you think about the concept of sixth-generation fighter jet? It may be out of your mind. While still at an early stage of development, several distinct characteristics common to many sixth-generation fighter concepts have evolved. The fifth-generation abilities for air-to-air capability, battlefield survivability in the anticipated anti-access, or area denial environment, and ground support or attack will need to be enhanced and adapted to the future threat environment. An initial focus on air superiority roles has moved away from close in dogfighting, which is becoming less common, and instead broadened to embrace ground support, cyber warfare, and even space warfare capabilities, with beyond visual range air-to-air missile capability remaining important. While current engines operate best at a single point in the flight envelope, sixth-generation engines are expected to have a variable cycle to give optimum efficiency at any speed or altitude, giving greater range, faster acceleration, and greater subsonic cruise efficiency. The engine would configure itself to act like a turbojet at supersonic speeds, while performing like a high-bypass turbofan for efficient cruising at slower speeds. The ability to supercruise will likely be available to aircraft with this engine type. The experts stated that have six bold concepts for sixth-generation fighters. The fighters will have one system for everything. Sixth-generation fighters could have a piece of gear that does multiple jobs, replacing different systems typically seen on today's aircraft. This hardware would include adaptable software that changes between tasks in mere nanoseconds. You no longer have a radar, no longer have electronic warfare, no longer have a radio, said Jason Tex Clark, Director for Advanced Mission Systems at Raytheon Technologies. Instead, you have multifunction hardware that does it all and can be repurposed very quickly, switching between functions so quickly it seems instantaneous. Fighters will become flying data centers. The computer processing power for sixth-gen fighters will reach staggering levels, taking the sophisticated mission computers aboard today's aircraft and essentially turning the planes into flying data centers. AI will be the wingman of the future. Pilots for futuristic sixth-gen fighters could have help from nearby planes flown autonomously through a concept known as manned-unmanned teaming. Future fighters will land on their own. Future aircraft may use new hardware and software to land autonomously on aircraft carriers. This type of technology is already advancing with the U.S. Navy and Marine Corps. Digital engineering will make costs clear up front. An endeavor as big as building a next-generation fighter aircraft is hard to predict. Small glitches and design choices can affect costs and schedules years into the future. A digital thread that connects all data available could help the military predict costs and performance more accurately. Future fighter sensors will be swappable. Sensors on aircraft today use common interfaces that allow them to talk to computers on aircraft. This standardization makes sense, considering the range of different and new hardware that may need to be plugged in one day. The feasibility of some of these characteristics remains uncertain. Development time and cost are likely to prove major factors in laying out practical roadmaps. Specific requirements are anticipated by some observers to crystallize around 2025 or 2030.